All right, Detroit, we are back. And it's time for us to continue our year two offseason with your Detroit Red Wings. Fresh off the year two NHL entry draft, where we attempted to land the first overall pick so we could take Jack Hughes, get that first line center, reunite the Hughes brothers here on a rebuilding Detroit. It would have been perfect, but we missed out on the first overall pick by one draft selection. Got pushed back to number four. Thankfully, Edmonton's pick moved up to number two, but the Minnesota Wild ended up getting the first overall pick, and I made the decision to not move up. And a lot of people were not happy with that. Superb man strategy draws concern. The best trades are the ones you don't make, right? Detroit, Michigan, GM Superb Man leaves the hockey world stunned as he did not use his draft capital to trade up to take highly touted Jack Hughes. I thought that the Minnesota Wild, we kind of took their prospect last year with the second overall pick, Evgeny Svechnikov, but it made sense last year. I made the argument that they're an aging team. They're trying to win the Stanley Cup. They moved up in the draft to get there. They have a bunch of forwards. I gave them Gustav Nyquist, so there's another winger to replace Svechnikov, at least temporarily. And if they win the cup, then it all works out. Well, they didn't win the cup. Not only that, they didn't make the playoffs. So second year in a row, and now they have the first overall selection with a guy like Jack Hughes available. It seemed way too unrealistic to make that trade. So I left it. The Minnesota Wild took Jack Hughes at number one. We're going to see if that comes back to bite us in the ass in a Stanley Cup final some way down the road. The Hughes brothers facing off against one another, but I'm still happy with our selections at two and number four. Number two, we got our center of the future, Logan Bochynski. He's a two-way left winger right now, but his face-off rating was fine, so I think when he's ready to play in the NHL, I'm going to switch him over to the center position, and that will take care of our 1-2 on the first and second line in the center role with Dylan Larkin and Logan Bochynski going forward. Don't know which one's going to be better, but still, it's nice to have. And then at number four, Donald Reinprecht. We got that defenseman. I'm hoping so much that he's not one of those floundering medium elite prospects. I'm hoping that this guy becomes at least an 88 overall top two bona fide defenseman. If not, at least he's going to be a top four defenseman for us. So you can see the prospect pool coming together. But it was a deep draft for us as well. Not just those two guys, Logan Bochynski and Reinprecht at 2 and 4, but Rudolph Braun as well. Low elite in the 70s already. McDermott, a goaltender, medium starter. If he doesn't make it for us, we can always end up trading him, but still good trade value right there. Hamill, low elites. Bois, low elite. It was a great draft for the Detroit Red Wings, and we are ready to go forward. But Rudolph Braun, this guy's going to be ready to play in the AHL next year. He's already, 72 overall? From Germany, the German Hockey News. We got a quote from him. "I am so proud to now play in the NHL. It was my biggest dream. Thanks so much for this great opportunity, GM Superb, and all of Detroit." Rudolph Braun. So we're going to see how this guy plays immediately, because he's going to be in the AHL 1 year of simulating. We'll get some advanced analytics on him, and we'll be able to see if this guy's going to be a part of the team or not. But it's a perfect, bottom six player, and if he only grows from there, that's great, man. That was a great draft for us. So we didn't get that first overall pick, but we got the depth, and now it's time to develop that depth. But I haven't given up on next year. Even though we're still going to hold on to our first overall pick, or our first rounder, I should say. And I think we got the St. Louis Blues. Yeah, we had the St. Louis Blues first overall pick for this year. Don't automatically think that, hey, we're going to turn this team around right now. We're going to make the playoffs in year number three. Technically, it's still only year number two, because a year number one we simulated, I wasn't in control of the team. I've only had one tank here, but I would like to at least try to compete this season. But look, a lot of our medium elite players, they're not going to be ready for year number three. Quinn Hughes, he's going to be ready. Svechnikov, he's going to be ready. Bochynski, our second overall pick, he's going to take until year number four to get going. So I'm thinking around year four and five is when we really start to come into our own. Donald Reinprecht, same thing, year four or five. Hedberg, year five or six, maybe year four if he gets a good jump this year. And then all these other guys like Bois and Hamill, low elite, if they grow, it's going to be by year four and five. So we're still ways away, but the way I have constructed this team, we may be able to at least compete for a playoff spot come the trade deadline. We have a first line now, Vladimir Sobotka, Franz Nielsen, and Patrick Berglund, and then the rest are the young players that we're going to bring up. But the defense and the goaltender is what we need, and thankfully, it's free agency right now, so we can pick up a few players. Now, I was reading your comments. A lot of people were saying go after Panarin, go after Wheeler, go after Kyle Connor, give up a draft pick for him. Mitch Marner is right back there again. Remember with Vegas, he signed with the Dallas Stars. I don't think he's going to sign there again this year. They already got John Tavares. But if a team gets Mitch Marner, that's really going to help them out. Gustav Nyquist, we can bring him back to Detroit. There's a lot of options here. But considering we still have a lot of big-time contracts on our team, because when we were rebuilding, we took on those contracts to get draft picks, we only have $12 million of cap space available. And like I said, I want to be competitive this year. At least I want to attempt to be competitive. So we've got to get a starting goaltender, a backup goaltender, and a pretty good defenseman. After that, we can make a signing or two, but I'm not going to have any cap space after that. So first up, the goaltenders. Jimmy Howard, we're not bringing back. What I'm going to try to do in this game is get one of these low 80 overall goaltenders, or a goalie in their low 80s, and try to grow him into a high 80 overall goaltender. It can happen. What they got to do is they got to have the starter potential. Grubauer has it. Jean-Luc Picard has it. Mrazek has it. They got to have good age on their side. These guys are still in their 20s. And they got to have a good season. If they can have all that, you can see a goaltender jump up to 85, 86, 87, 88 overall. I've seen it before. So I think we're going to try that. But to make sure that happens, we got to make sure... I got to think about this. See, the problem, I was thinking about Picard and Grubauer, but they're the same overall, 82-82. If you play them 82-82 with the automated goalie rotations, they'll play around like 40 to 50 games. You want one of these goaltenders playing close to like 60 games and having a good season. That's the way he grows. So we went with Jean-Luc Picard with the Las Vegas Golden Knights. Let's go with Philip Grubauer, baby. Is he German? He can be roommates with Rudolf Braun. There you go. All right, so Philip Grubauer, I'm going to offer a contract to 1 year, because if he grows, we want to give him that extension before the next season so we can get him out of steel. So I'm going to go 1 year at $2 million just to make sure this goes through. And our backup, I want to make sure, is one overall less. So we're going to go with Mason, Montoya, Pavel. Now we're going to go with Khudobin. All right, Anton Khudobin is going to be our backup. So 1 year at 1.7 for Anton. There you go. So there is our goaltender situation taken care of. And defenseman, we got DeKaiser. We traded for Eric Johnson, who's got 4 years left, and that's the magic number, 4 and 3 years. After that, all the bad contracts are gone. Xavier Ouletz, I tendered a qualifying offer. I don't know if I want to bring him back. Roenick, Chalowski, and Quinn Hughes are all going to be ready for this year. So I need one more defenseman, and then you got DeKaiser, Johnson, and those three other guys. You might be able to pull it all together. So I'm looking at Jake Gardner. Jake Gardner's stats are pretty good. 28 years of age. He wants 3 years, so I can give him that four-year deal, same as Eric Johnson. Go up to $6 million per season. I can afford that. Didn't have the greatest year last year, but remember, 2018... or 17-18 is also a simulated year. That's more like it. 24 points, more assists. But I like his advanced analytics. It's not like real-life Jake Gardner. This guy actually plays well defensively. He hits in this. 132 block shots, 119. A little too many giveaways this season, but maybe the Toronto Maple Leafs just weren't a good team, because last year, those are some pretty good stats for a guy who also produces. So Jake Gardner, we are going to bring to the Detroit Red Wings. Well, we're going to attempt to bring. 4 years at $6 million. Exact same contract as Eric Johnson, and these two can be our veteran defensemen and give time for guys like Roenick, Hughes, Chalowski, and Donald Reinprecht to get ready to grow. 4 years sounds about right for us. So Jake Gardner, there you go. So I got $6 million tied up right there. $2 million. We're around like $9 million right now. So all these forwards guys, Blake Wheeler, Panarin, Logan Couture would have been a nice one to fill up the center core. But 7 years, no thank you for a guy who's 30 years of age. We got to go in the other direction. Youth. Max Pacioretty would have been good. But as well, also, like, we're not exactly a destination hotspot for these veteran players who can still contribute to a championship team, right? They want to go play with Pittsburgh or Nashville, who just won the cup, or Winnipeg, who won the cup in year number one. So we're going to avoid signing any of these guys. I already have my teams. As I said, we just got to get Jake Gardner and these two goaltenders, and the lineups are set. I could use a few injury players, some depth players, but I'll take care of that myself in preseason, because we also do want to stack the AHL squad because of all those younger players, like Rudolph Braun. I want to make sure the AHL squad has a great season. So hang on a second. Let's just advance a few days, make sure we get Jake the Snake, Grubauer, and Khudobin signed, and then we can take it to year number three. And I don't know how we're going to go with the simulation for year number three. If we're competitive, I might take my time with it. So Anton Khudobin is on our team. Jake the Snake Gardner has decided to sign with the Detroit Red Wings. I want to see some fan art for that. And Philip Grubauer as well. All right, so the team is slowly coming together. We're still a rebuilding squad, boys. So $4.7 million of cap space available. Let me just go to UFA. Forwards, what do we got here? $2 million, so I can sign these guys down here. Hank Sedin, Molson, Dzingel, Gionta. What is that? Is that, no, that's Riley Nash. That's not Rick Nash, right? Yeah, that's Riley Nash. Colin Wilson. Now we got everyone we need. There are some RFAs available, but I'm going to hold on to my draft picks. We have a team, and if we end up having a bad season, guess what? We can have another great draft pick. So it's not exactly a tank year, but it's a lower expectations year. We're just going to try to be competitive with our younger players, let them grow. Whatever happens over the course of the season happens, but we're going to take our time with this. So we're not going to commit to any big-time free agents. So let's get to the next season, boys, and I will build the AHL team by myself. Hang on one second, boys. I forgot you guys do like to see where other players go in free agency, so I thought I'd show you guys. We're at the 18th of July, so a couple weeks after free agency. Let's go to the activity feed and see where some of these players ended up going. Hang on a second. Signings. There you go. All right, so Joe Thornton went to the New York Islanders. Lord knows why. Fuck, Tavares already left that dump. Why is Joe Thornton going there for 1 year as well? The Vancouver Canucks signed Tyler Meyer, so a right-handed defenseman for them. Matt Molson went to the San Jose Sharks. Pavlik, Mathot, Al Montoya. All right, hang on a second here. Dzingel, Zetterlund, Schnarr, Westerlund, Calvin Picard, Jean-Luc goes to the Pittsburgh Penguins. Oscar Dank. All right, I guess these other players. There you go. Henrik Sedin to the San Jose Sharks. So they gave up a Thornton, and they inherit a Sedin. Very good. Zdeno Chara back with the Ottawa Senators. A four-year contract. What the fuck? How old is he now? Like in this, like 41, 42? 4 years. All right, he's playing until he's 45. The Islanders added Logan Couture. Ooh, so it actually, the Sharks just went to the island. Well, maybe that's why Joe Thornton went there. That actually makes a little bit more sense now. Logan and Joe. Gustav Nyquist. Oh my God, Logan, Joe, and Gustav Nyquist all go to the Islanders. Look at that. They are building their team through free agency. Matt Zuccarello to the Colorado Avalanche. Max Pacioretty to the San Jose Sharks. So San Jose loses Thornton and Couture. They get Sedin and Pacioretty. What the hell? Artemi Panarin goes to the Vancouver Canucks. That's a good one. And Blake Wheeler goes to the St. Louis Blues. All these teams, that's not good for us, because remember, we traded for the first overall pick for the St. Louis Blues, and now they got Blake Wheeler. That's not good for us. I was hoping that pick would be a little bit better than that. All right, boys. So more fan art, all right? Faces, new faces, and new places. That Panarin one in Vancouver and Wheeler in St. Louis, those are big ones. And freaking San Jose and the Islanders, man. And the Islanders built their team. My God. Nyquist, Logan, and Joe Thornton all through free agency to the island. All right. Now, let's get to preseason. All right. So, here we are in preseason for year number three. It's really only year two for me, but October of 2019. I got the NHL and AHL squads ready to go. I might as well show you guys, but don't expect anything incredible here. It's slim pickings for year number three with the Detroit Red Wings. So, the first line, we have Vladimir Sobotka, Franz Nielsen, and Patrick Berglund. Ooh, man. Not exactly lighting the league on fire with this first line. But remember the plan. Every single one of these players take the puck away more than they give it away. I'm just hoping that first line can be responsible, be defensive, and stay positive the entire year. I'll take an even first line as well, because it's a growth year. And here's where the growth starts. Second line, rookie season for Evgeny Svechnikov, boys. I want to see some fan art for him. He's playing alongside of Dylan Larkin, who's 85 overall still, and Anthony Mantha, who is 83. He started last year at 84. I think the reason he dropped off was his lack of point production. Last season, it was just an applicator on that second line with them. This year, it's a sniper, so I'm hoping that his production numbers go up, and every single one of these players, second line forward. So it's going to be interesting to see how they produce this season. I'm not putting them on the first line because put them on the first line, maybe they're not ready for it, the team doesn't play well, and now they suffer. Second line behind these defensive first liners, they can produce and they can thrive. Third line, we got Justin Abdelkader, Jacob Forsbacka Carlson, rookie season for him as well, and Andrei Svechnikov, rookie season for him also. So you can see the middle six is just pure growth. We got five players that we're trying to grow in our middle six. Forsbacka Carlson, the Svechnikovs, Larkin, and Mantha. Abdelkader we know is good defensively, so I'm going to put him on the third line to help these two guys out. So you got four good defensive players there, but four good defensive veterans with five young players that you're trying to grow in the top nine. And then the fourth line, Tyler Bertuzzi, Andreas Athanasiou, whatever his name is, and Michael Rasmussen, who is 77 overall, fourth line forward, so I got to play him in the NHL. His stats do not look good, but we'll see what he can do with like a two-way forward playmaker and a sniper combination on the fourth line. We'll see what they can do. Defensively, Jake the Snake Gardner is going to be playing alongside of Philip Hronik. Quinn Hughes is going to be playing alongside of Eric Johnson. And Danny DeKeyser is going to be playing alongside of Chalowski. I couldn't put Hughes and Hronik and Chalowski all on the top six position, and I didn't want to play them alongside of one another just because that top six would be weak. So I don't know if this is going to work out for their growth, but I've split them up with all the veterans. So there's a veteran and a rookie prospect on each line, because each one of these defensemen, Hronik, Hughes, and Chalowski, are all rookies. So how many rookies is that starting this year? Like seven or eight rookies for the Detroit Red Wings? My God. Special teams looks like this. We got Mantha, Larkin, and the Svechnikovs. We got three wingers. Four forwards on the power play line with Jake Gardner. And then the second power play line, Forsbacka Carlson, Franz Nielsen, Rasmussen. So we got the two young prospects. We're hoping that can score goals. Forsbacka Carlson with the shots, and Rasmussen because he's a sniper. Quinn Hughes gets some time on the power play as well, and Eric Johnson. All right, so there's the power play. Four-man power play looks like that. Penalty kill, I'm going to utilize the defensive players this year, Dylan Larkin and Mantha. Last year, I kept them off the penalty kill. This season, we're going to run with them. I want their ice time to be up there. And also, they're good defensive players. So they're with Jake Gardner, Eric Johnson, Franz Nielsen, and Patrick Berglund, the second-line penalty kill. Three-man penalty kill looks like that. Extra attackers, 4-on-4, looks like that. Continued, 3-on-3, looks like that. Extra attackers, Larkin and Franz Nielsen. I was going to put Mantha in there, but they're on the same line, Larkin and him, so no point. Shootout, Larkin, Svechnikov, Mantha, and Forsbacka Carlson. I cannot even talk right now. What the hell is going on? And in the net, Philip Grubauer and Anton Godobin. And I'm hoping for a really good year out of Philip Grubauer. If he's close to 40 wins, which is a lot, if he's over 30, that might do it. It's save percentage and goals against. I think that has a little bit to do, but I think it's just overall, like your wins, how your team plays. If our team is close to being a playoff team and he is clearly a good goaltender, I think I could give him a 3-year extension at like $3 million. He might turn into like an 85, 86 overall goaltender. And then we have a stud who is extremely extremely cheap. He got an 86 overall goaltender making $3 million per season. That's great. And then he can turn into trade bait in his last year. So that's the NHL squad, boys. We're going to see how much growth we can get out of these young players. AHL, I picked up a few players like Hunter Shinkaruk. Braun is on the first line. So it's Shinkaruk, Braun, and Seth Griffin. Griffith. The Grand Rapid Griffins. Jesus, that's what screwed me up. Griffith on the Griffins. Holmstrom and Carlson, Giovanni Smith, Zach Gallant, and Alan Quinn. And then there he is, Johan Hedberg, the left-wing sniper. He's alongside of two super Swedes. I went out and got Emil Peterson. He's Swedish, all right. And Oscar Mahler. We had him last year. He's Swedish as well. So a Swedish fourth line to help out Hedberg. I think he's also, I kept him off the power play this year because I want the team to do better than they did last year. I know they won the Calder, but the regular season numbers weren't the greatest. And if we want them to grow, we got to have a really good regular season. And there's the two goaltenders, all right? So there are all the players, the injury, or the scratch players that can bring in when we have injuries. Troy Brouwer, Marcus Foligno, and Xavier Ouellette, who decided to sign our qualifying offer for RFA. He's only 79 overall. He had no trade value, so I thought I'll hold on to him. Now, we got to go to settings here for a second. I remember a comment about last year's injuries being way too low. So the injuries, we're going to turn up to 20. There you go. All right, and automated goalie rotations is definitely still on. So we're going to let Philip Grubauer run this season. Doesn't matter if we're winning or losing. It's not the kind of year where we can make trades or a lot of line changes to affect our gameplay. I mean, it is what it is. We're in a tough division as well. The Tampa Bay Lightning, who went to the Stanley Cup Finals 2 years in a row now, lost to Winnipeg, lost to Nashville. The Toronto Maple Leafs, they're a young up-and-coming team. Boston Bruins, I made their rosters much better. So Pasternak, you know, Buffalo with Jack Eichel and Rasmus Ristolainen now year number three. It's a tough division. Oh, and look at this. Game number one. This is perfect because I wanted to go into the game now with this GM mode. And game number one on home ice, Jack Hughes and the Minnesota Wild. No freaking way. Hang on a second. View lines. I want to take a look at the Minnesota Wild lines. Are we going to get to see Jack Hughes, the first overall pick, playing in Detroit? Oh, there he is, boys. There he is. Jack Hughes alongside Mikko Koivu and Zach Parise. Where's Zetterberg? Zetterberg's down there. They lost Gustav Nyquist. Oh, Jack Hughes. That'd have been such a nice player. But we get to see what he looks like out there. All right. So this is what we're going to be doing a lot more in this GM mode series and all GM mode series going forward for the next game. I want to jump into the game a lot more, especially for meaningful games. And this is opening night with Jack Hughes in the building, boys. So let's go. All right. Simulate, unless it's a ridiculous score in the third and there's no way we're coming back. I won't worry about it. Oh, and last thing, hang on a second. Some people were saying to make Dylan Larkin the captain. I decided not this year. This is still a rebuilding year. So we just got alternates for the seniority Detroit Red Wing players, all right? Danny DeKeyser, Justin Abdelkader, and now we're grooming, all right, Dylan Larkin to become our captain. So he's got the alternate this year, boys. When the team starts to become competitive and he puts this team on his shoulders and leads them to the playoffs, then I'll give him the C, all right? But here it is, opening night, the Minnesota Wild in town with Jack Hughes to face the Detroit Red Wings. Game one of the regular season, year number three. I want a solid start, boys. First period, yeah, baby. Franz Nielsen on the first line. That first line, boys, what did I say? They can get it done. Second period, ooh, two goals scored. Jack Hughes, the first goal for the Minnesota Wild in year number three, and it's their rookie, the first overall pick, Jack Hughes, who scores. Jason Zucker gets the lead for the Minnesota Wild, so we're down by one. Let's get into this game and watch the third period. Jack Hughes is Minnesota Wild versus Quinton Hughes' Detroit Red Wings. Oh my God, let's go. And here we are in Detroit, Hockey Town, USA, third period between the Detroit Red Wings and the Minnesota Wild. Opening night here for year number three. Two teams that have failed in the last few years, missing out on the playoffs, but two teams who have gotten themselves some very nice young prospects. Jack Hughes already has his first career NHL goal in this game. We're going to see him out there again. It's the team's two first lines right now, so let's see. We got Ryan Sutter into the middle. Great save there by Philip Grubauer, who I'm hoping for a great season from. Franz Nielsen, no speed into the middle, though. Patrick Berglund, here we go. The Detroit Red Wings, those veterans, those grindy two-way forwards. Get those takeaways, baby. Oh, Sabatka. Well, there's a giveaway. Pass back all the way back to Grubauer. Grubauer up to Gardner. Not Gardner. Don't give it the breakout to Jake Gardner. That's not a good combination. Jason Zucker looking for his second of the game. Rolling back to the point. Shielding the puck over to the middle to Granlund. Shot block. Vladimir Sabatka. The Detroit Red Wings first line doing their job. Not allowing chances. They're not going to create offense necessarily. Oh, wait a minute. Ooh, Jared Spurgeon, though. Blocks that cross seam pass there. Oh, man, that would have been... And there he is. Jack Hughes, the windmill. He's even got a black visor into the middle. Jared Spurgeon, Jack Hughes. Oh, it's special. This kid is going to be something special. He's got a great playmaking touch, too. And he sprays the goaltender. Number 10, Jack Hughes. What a great first shift there. He comes off, does a freaking... Well, let's go back and take a look at this. The first time we get to see Jack Hughes playing here. Oh, it's Studley. Look at this shift. This is the kind of player you want. Immediately comes off the bench. They recognize the stud is on the ice. They give him the pass. Look at this. Oh, he's got a black mullet as well. Look at that windmill right there. Oh, my God. And our future captain, Dylan Larkin, goes up the ice. Look at this. passing in the middle. Jared Spurgeon, that's a 10 beller chance right there. Gets it again. Pass it to Koivu. Shot on the net. Drives the net and sprays the goaltender. What a shift that is, man. Adik, two great passes, and then gets the faceoff. Oh, Jack Hughes. We're going to be seeing plenty of him, boys, in the future. Number 10. Woo! Hopefully I don't have to face him in the playoffs, the Stanley Cup Finals. I think I said that already. That would be bad. All right, so Larkin's Svechnikov and Mantha. Hughes, Parise, Koivu. Come on, it's my second line. Good face-off win. Svechnikov! Here we go. E, Svechnikov. Over to Larkin. Larkin off the left wing. Dumps it in. There you go, Larkin. Good play. Leading the team. Svechnikov to Mantha. Mantha turns. Back to Quinn Hughes. Jack Johnson. Oh, baby, what a shot. What? That must have hit the goaltender. I don't think he made the save. What a clap bomb right there from Anthony Mantha. He's got one, let me tell you. In the middle, Jack Hughes finds Spurgeon again, who's jumping up in this play. Back to Matthew Dumba. Slap shot from the point along the ice. Here goes Quinton Hughes, baby. The Hughes brothers are out there together. Here we go. Svechnikov, number 14. Looks like Shanahan. Back to Johnson. Oh, what a save. No, it's shot in. Is that Hughes? Is that Quinton Hughes? Quinton Hughes in his rookie game, or his first career NHL game, gets his first career NHL goal. The Hughes brothers facing off against one another, and they both score in their first career NHL game. What a story, boys. See, this is why I want to jump into the game a lot more. You can see some crazy shit. And the game is actually not that bad for AI tied game. I mean, I'm not going to jump in at the end when we're down by one with 1 minute, because they don't know how to play with goaltender or a pulled goalie and AI or programming or whatever word I'm looking for. But even strength is just fine. You get to see stuff like this. Quinton Hughes driving the slot, picks up that puck, and buries what we hope to be the first of many here with the Detroit Red Wings. Oh my God, what a start. All right, so we got a 2-2 game here. 10 minutes left. Yeah, I'm liking the speed of this game. This is fine. I can do this. Advocator. Svechnikov, Andre. Oh, another rookie for the Detroit Red Wings. Man, he's tall out there. Andre's got some size to him. Advocator doing a good job. There's Henrik Zetterberg back in the Joe. Oh, it's not the Joe. What's the arena called? I'm calling it the Joe. Back in the Joe is Zetterberg. Here we go. Greenway. Back to Zetterberg. Zetterberg, baby. You got to watch out for him. He's going to be a Red Wing killer if he's playing against the Zetterberg. Finds Greenway. In, oh, down low. Grabauer. Great save. Force back of Carlson. Up to Andrei Svechnikov. Here he is. Off the right wing. Gets around the defender. Behind the net. Force back up. Force doesn't shoot. Abdelkader. He's got all those shots. Didn't shoot. Abdelkader back to the point. Here we go. Over to Chalowski. Back to DeKaiser. Danny DeKaiser. Bad pass right up there in the middle. Man, the veteran making bad passes. Give it to the young players. They know what they're doing. And that's going to go 200 feet the other way for an icing call. The upcoming games for the Detroit Red Wings. They're at the Minnesota Wild. They're at Edmonton. And they're at San Jose. They're next three. So a road trip after opening night here. They want to start year number three on the right foot. Let's get this game won, baby. Chalowski. Back to DeKaiser. Slaps it this time. Rebound in front. Puck is bouncing. Minnesota Wild are going to clear it up. Eriksson Ek up to Zetterberg. Two super Swedes. Back to Eriksson Ek. Oh, wrist shot. Good save, Grabauer. It's sitting there in the crease. And look who's sitting on top looking for that goal. Oh, the old captain. Oh, Henrik Zetterberg, as we get a look at Quinton Hughes scoring his first goal in the NHL. Fantastic. All right, face-off in the Detroit Red Wings zone. Defensive zone face-off. Athanasiu loses it. That's what we got you on the fourth line for. God damn it. Pollock, Olsen, slap shot blocked in front by the Minnesota Wild player. Athanasiu is going to dump it in. That's what the fourth line does. Let's see what Rasmussen can do. Is he out there? That's Bertuzzi. Tyler Bertuzzi's in there working the forecheck, doing a good job. Is that Rasmussen, number 15? Rasmussen wins the puck, gets it back to the point. Eric Johnson finds Quinn Hughes. Back to Johnson. Oh, slap shot on front, blocked by the Minnesota Wild. Behind the net, Tyler Bertuzzi's going to pick it up, doing a good job here at the fourth line. Playing the offensive zone for the fourth line is always great. Quinn Hughes back to Johnson. Puck is right there in the middle. Roman Pollock loses it. Oh, Tyler Bertuzzi rings one off the bar. Rasmussen doing a good job getting the puck here. Haven't seen him shoot, but he's been forechecking well. Franz Nielsen now back to Hughes. Back to Nielsen. What a save. Devin Dubnyk keeps his team in this game. Franz Nielsen, the first liner. A great feed from the young Quinn Hughes to find Nielsen right in the slot. But a better glove save there by Devin Dubnyk. Throwing up that mitt. All right. Dylan Larkin, offensive zone faceoff. He loses it to Jack Hughes. It's Hughes out there, boys. But Anthony Mantha, who's got the shot. He's got a man behind him. Gets it back to Roenick. Roenick to Jake Gardner, the newest acquisition from free agency. Jake Gardner making those mistakes. Yeah, I've seen that plenty of times in Toronto. Aaron passes, and now here comes Minnesota. Oh, man, it's a fan of a shot. And here come the Detroit Red Wings back the other way. Up to Anthony Mantha. He's got some space. No, you can't do that. That's going to be offside for certain. 30 seconds left here in opening night. Jonas Brodin, he gets forechecked by Anthony Mantha, moving his legs. Evgeny Svechnikov back to Roenick, back to Gardner, back to Roenick. Roenick cuts to the middle. You're going to have to pass that, Jake Gardner. Whoa, one-timer! Just misses the net. You can see Mantha shooting that puck, man. Mantha has a clap bomb. Might have to put him on the point for the power play. Here we go. The Minnesota Wild looking to end it late. 10 seconds, but Detroit doing a great job defensively. Gardner gets it up. Berglund, the defensive first line. Patrick Berglund into the middle. Franz Nielsen, just throw it at the net, Berglund. Oh, and we're going overtime. All right, so we got a point. It's a Western Conference team, so we don't have to worry about giving them a point. It's not the end of the world. But what a great story, man. Opening night, a bunch of first career NHL games for both teams here. Detroit has so many rookie players. But the big two, you know, number four last year, number one this year, the Hughes brothers, both scoring for their respective team. I mean, that's got to be a great story. You know, when they retire one year, hey, kid, remember that? Remember our rookie game we both played in Detroit against each other, and we both scored. Oh, who's going to be the overtime hero, though? We got Larkin and Mantha, Granlund and Niederreiter. All right, so I don't know what their three-on-three lines look like. Jack Hughes might be on the third line. He might not even be playing because he's only 80 overall. Oh, wait a minute. Anthony Mantha's got some space. Three-on-three. We're going to be going back and forth here, ladies and gentlemen. Strap yourselves in. No defense to be seen. Whichever team gets the puck is going to have a huge chance unless someone just turns the puck over ridiculously. Larkin and Mantha again. All right, Larkin. I'm liking your face-off so far. Show me that you're better than Granny Smith over there. Dylan Larkin. Yeah, wins it clean. Gardner, Mantha! Mantha just misses that post. Mantha is a shooter. My God, got to work on that accuracy. It's a heavy shot, though. Here comes. Oh, big turnover. Good job. All right, so we didn't get the puck back, but we stopped their rush. Oh, there it is. Larkin playing. Oh, but he loses it. Larkin, he loses it. Oh, what a bad check right there. Jake the Snake. Gardner saves a breakaway. I never thought I'd say that. Anthony Mantha tries a windmill into the middle. That's a bad turnover on 3-on-3. Had puck possession. 2 minutes left. Here come the Minnesota Wild. It's a 2-on-1. Drop pass. Niederreiter. 3-on-1. Suter. Down low. Granlund. They don't get a shot. In the middle, Suter! Oh my God, how do you not get a shot from that? Oh, here's the shot. Suter! Oh my! Low glove earns that contract! And game one of the year three season goes to the Minnesota Wild. I don't know why I said game one. It's not a playoff series. Opening night goes to Minnesota. The Detroit Red Wings, they get their point, but they lose their first game. All right, so it looks like Jack Hughes got the better end of it. See what I mean? 3-on-3 possession. What are you going to do? That's just a snip. Can't blame Grubauer for that. Got to blame whoever's defending or who should have been defending Suter. Snip daddy. All right. Very good, very good. So let's get a good month of simulating in. We're definitely going to take it slower here with year number three. Woo! That was good. All right. So crazy first game of the season up against the Minnesota Wild. That was a lot of fun. I was thinking about ending the video on that note, but we don't have any simulating and I would like to get some advanced analytics and simulated points up so that we can make some decisions on line changes or any trades for the next video. Because if we just end it there, I got nothing to do for the next video except for simulating on my own. So we're going to take it to the end of November, okay? We're going to go all the way down here. We're going to see how the team plays. Don't expect much from this team. I'm hoping that we can just be respectable and competitive, but it's more about growing that middle six, right? That's why our first line is lackluster, because we're trying to grow the middle six, and look at this, 0-4-1 to start the year, not good, 1-4-1. I can always make a few line changes, but realistically, you guys can see the team that we have on paper. It's just not deep, we don't have the studs, we don't have the goaltending yet, it's a growth year, all right? It's not a tank year, it's a growth year. Yeah, 2-8-1, it's not the greatest, 3-8-1, come on, get some W's here before the end of November so I can at least justify keeping these lines together. But we're not making any trades to try and improve this season. I will make some line changes. I'll listen to you guys to make some line changes, but not at the expense of growth. So Detroit player Jacob Forsbacka Carlson's been injured with a sore shoulder. Estimated return is November 19th. Do I not have any? What? I got to call up a player. I thought I had three players. All right, hang on a second. All right, I figured out what the problem was. It wasn't just Forsbacka Karlsson. Our backup goaltender, Anton Khudobin, got injured as well, so I had to bring up a goalie, all right? So Gillies is up here, and we got Marcus Foligno as the third-line center. Just for now, I can always change that up. Forsbacka Karlsson is going to be back in, like, what would it say, 9 days? Anton Khudobin is ready to play as well. I'm just going to continue until Karlsson comes back. That way I can make the change at the same time. It said, like, what, 9 days? Didn't say long, did it? Maybe, you know what? Maybe he came back. Oh, there he is. Oh, Eric Johnson's now been injured. Shit! Hang on a sec. All right, so the injuries are screwing with me. People are getting injured at the same time as others, and then they're coming back at the same time as others, so I'm not getting the right reports. Forsbacka Karlsson is back in the third line, and goaltenders Anton Khudobin is back. And to replace Eric Johnson on the second line, we got Xavier Ouellette. So you see what I mean about the lack of depth? When we have an injury to some of these players, our veterans, we just have no one to come up. Forsbacka, okay, there, that's the one to come up. All right, so I already got him back in. All right, so let's just finish this last month of November. Oh, my God, man. All right, hang on a sec again. All right, so Eric Johnson's now back in there. Can we just get to the end of the month? Maybe the injuries are too high here at 20. Oh, my God, injury again. Yeah, you guys wanted the injuries from 10 to 20. I don't know. I might have to go back down to 10. There's another injury. Dylan Larkin has been injured with a sprained ankle. All right, assistant coach replaced player. Should we just get, we're limping here to the end of November, boys. It's not good for the Detroit Red Wings. Oh, he's back. Oh, my God. All this micromanaging. And I could do power video editing, but then I got to micromanage my video editing. God damn it, man. All right, Dylan Larkin back in there. Can we just get to the end? Can we just get to the end? Can we just get to the end? 5-2 loss to the LA Kings. 4-3 loss to the Boston Bruins and the Washington Capitals. There you go. All right. So we are done the first 2 months, and our record is 7-13-3. So it's not crazy to think that we can come back from that. All you'd have to do is win 6 in a row, and you're back to .500. We're still in the first half of the season. You know, I've seen teams turn it around, but usually they're the teams that you expect to make the playoffs. They just have a bad start, and then all of a sudden they win 10 in a row. We're not that team, all right? So Dylan Larkin, we'll take a look at some of the stats. We want these guys to grow. So if they're not producing on the second line, if they're not producing with their line mates, that's what I want you guys to chime in on. I don't want change this line so that you start winning more games. It's not going to work like that. It's a growth year, all right? So that's what I'm looking for. So Atlantic Division, where's Detroit? There you go. So take a look at some of these. Goals for per game, 1.83, not scoring enough. Goals against per game, 2.87. Better than Ottawa, better than Buffalo. All right, it's not great, but we're not the worst. Power play percentage, 13.6. All right, so we are not scoring goals at all. Penalty kill percentage, look at that. Our penalty kill is 84.6. So with Larkin and Mantha and Nielsen and Berglund on the penalty kill, we're just fine. So we got to find a way to score a few more goals here. Power play could be enhanced. All right, so player stats. Now let's take a look at this first. Forwards, all right, so Franz Nielsen. He's got 12 points. He's a minus 8. So the first line ain't doing great, but what are you going to do? I mean, there's nothing much I could do. They're minus 9, minus 7. 2 goals, 5 assists. All right, so for Sobotka and Berglund. Larkin is a minus 6. Svechnikov, all right. Mantha. All right, so they're not doing great, these guys. They're on pace for like 40, 50-point seasons. Minus 6, minus 10, minus 10. So I could switch these guys up a little bit. Everyone's a minus, though. This is the problem. Forsbacka Karlsson, only 4 goals. How many shots does he have? Hang on a sec. Maybe I got to get Forsbacka Karlsson first-line power play time. Forsbacka Karlsson, 52 shots. So even with his ice time way down there, he's got those 4 goals. Hey, is that the most on the team? He's got to be up there. Yeah, Forsbacka Karlsson and Rasmussen. Look at Rasmussen as well. 7 points. Doing pretty good on the fourth line and the first line or the second line power play. All right. So I don't exactly know. I'd have to take a moment to think about how we could arrange these lines. You guys see what I see. If you see anything that I could do, let me know. All right. So there's the forwards. Defenseman, Jake Gardner, having a good year. Good. Roenick, good. Eric Johnson, not great. Minus 10. So Quinn Hughes, minus 11. DeKaiser and Chalowski. So other than Jake Gardner and Roenick, the other two lineups are not working. It's a rough year, man. It's a rough year. Grabauer, 8.96. Yeah, he's not going to grow with that kind of season. So, yeah, it doesn't look like we're going to be able to salvage this year, boys. We're going to have to just take another draft pick, it looks like. But, you know, we could always never know. Like, we could get a lucky simulation and turn it around, get above 500, and then fight it out from there on out. But if we have another 7-13 run, Like, in the next video, it'll be over. Like, we've got to turn it around. We got to turn it around now. We can't get to 20 losses and be below 500. No way, no how you're not going to make the playoffs like that. So, that is that. Let me take a look at the lines quickly for the AHL squad, see if anybody is growing down there. Rudolph Braun's up to 76. So, he grows, man. 2 goals, 6 assists, 8 points. Might not be a point producer, though. Might be like a defensive player. Don't know just yet. Giovanni Smith. All right. Hedberg. Let's see. Hedberg. Yep. 4 goals, 3 assists, -4. That's all right. Just get him going. Defensively. Yeah, we got nobody else and goaltenders. All right. So we're going to leave it right there. You guys let me know what kind of line combinations we could have. Also got to keep an eye on the St. Louis Blues. Where are the St. Louis Blues here? Hang on. St. Louis, Minnesota, St. Louis. There they are. St. Louis has a record currently of 10-15-0. Now, all they have to do is win 5 games, get back to 500, and work it from there. I've seen it before. And they got Tarasenko. They just signed Wheeler. They got Petrangelo. They have a team. But, you know, if they end up dropping the ball, we end up dropping the ball. You got 2 more top draft picks, eligible draft picks. Got another top pick, and that's really your team then, because you draft class. Hang on. What do we got coming up this season? Let's see. What do we got showing up in the draft this season? We got John Guerin, offensive defenseman. All right. Gavin Rodriguez, left wing, two-way forward. Alexis Lafreniere. Yeah, Lafreniere, center playmaker. That could be the one that we want, right? Staples, Murphy, Horton, Lucic. Looks like it's a defenseman year, which is good. We could land another offensive defenseman or Lucic, this two-way defenseman, or even a defensive defenseman at this point. That wouldn't be a bad bet, but also if we could land that first-line center that Alexis Lafreniere. Ooh, baby. Then we could just leave Bochinski as a left-wing two-way forward, and boom, right? So, yeah, man, it's still a rebuilding year, boys. It's not a tank year. I want to try to get better, but if we fail, we still have 2 top draft picks. Come back with our rookies for next year, like Ryan Preck, Logan Bochinski, Braun, draft Guerin, draft the other guy, and this team will be ready by year number 4 and 5, I guarantee you. So let me know. I want to see fan art. There'll be a link in the comments section, and I will see you guys next time. Hey guys, Johnny here, and thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give us a like, hit that subscribe button, and make sure notifications are on so you don't miss out on any new content. You can also swing by our website, which has forums and a live chat. That, along with Twitter, allows us to play with our subscribers in our GTA lobbies or the 24/7 open Minecraft server, where you can build with others or play in one of the many mini-games across Superbia. Our Patreon account helps us support our website and the Minecraft server, and we also live stream on Twitch, where I take days off my life for your entertainment. Sonny Gray, get out of it.
You stupid pieces of I should have gone with Jose for Fernandez. Oh my God, pitching change. Fernandez, get your ass in there. Oh, I swear to God, baseball God just decided all over me. Grand slam, oh yeah. Make me miss the playoffs with a first ranked team. Year 2, 30 games above 500, no divisional win, trip to the wild card. First inning.